Is Jagan Mohan Reddy imitating Pharaoh Akhenaten of Egypt, who in 1350 BC shifted his capital from Thebes to Akhetaten, 365 miles south of Cairo? Or is the chief minister of the newly formed Andhra state behaving like psychopath ruler Mohammed bin Tughlaq, who overnight decided to shift his capital from Delhi to Daulatabad in 1327? Jagan, it seems, has a similar plan for Andhra.
Amravati will no longer be our only capital. We will have three capitals.
Amravati, which will be the legislative capital, Vishakapatnam the administrative capital, and Kurnool will host the judiciary. Shifting capitals is not easy, as both former rulers failed miserably and who either realized their folly in the lifetimes or their successor did. But then in modern times, staying in capital cities is a pain because of collapsing infrastructure. Take Mumbaikers, who spend 11 days in a year stuck in traffic jams. Or for that matter, Delhi, where the problem of pollution seems to be unsolvable. But is Jagan doing it for similar reasons? Or is there another agenda? It seems Jagan has learned from the mistake of his political rival N. Chandrababu Naidu, who developed just one city in his first stint as Andhra Pradesh CM.
Hyderabad.
And repeated his mistake in his second stint by focusing again on just one city, Amravati, in the newly formed Andhra state. Mistakes that proved disastrous for his political career, losing his first re-election in 2004 in undivided Andhra Pradesh to Jagan's father, Y.S.R. Reddy, and in 2019 to his son, Jagan. Naidu seemed to have forgotten about rural areas and small towns of Andhra, who formed the bulk of voters and threw him out. Jagan, on the other hand, is putting his political eggs in three different baskets in the hope to spread his development work to wider audiences. Interestingly, Andhra region has been ruled by a half a dozen capitals in its small history. First, by Madras, when it was part of Madras Presidency. Then in 1952, noted Gandhian leader Potti Sriramalu, upset by Tamil domination, made a drastic move.
I am going on a fast unto death, until Telugu-speaking people are given a separate state.
Sriramalu's death after fasting for 35 days on December 15, 1952, led to a massive agitation, forcing Nehru, who never expected such an outcome, to form India's first state based on linguistics. The state of Andhra will be formed on the first day of October 1953. Carved out of Madras Presidency, the new Andhra state excluded Hyderabad city, as it was then part of Hyderabad state and Kurnool was made its capital. Later, as India shifted to states on a linguistic basis, on November 1, 1956, Hyderabad city and Telangana regions of Hyderabad state were merged into Andhra Pradesh. But before that, there was a gentleman's agreement between chief ministers of the two states.
You must ensure safeguards of Telangana people from discrimination by the Andhra government. Okay.
Unfortunately, this gentleman's promise was not kept, which led to another leader going on fast in 2009. KCR.
We need a separate state of Telangana.
This time the central government didn't wait for anyone to die. In 11 days, Dr. Manmohan Singh relented.
The process to form a separate Telangana state will be initiated.
Leading to the formation of a new state of Telangana on June 2, 2014, with KCR becoming its first chief minister and Chandrababu Naidu of Andhra. In a reversal of fortunes, Jagan beat Naidu in the 2019 state elections but was in a minority in the legislative council where TDP had a majority, who blocked all bills passed by Jagan, including his pet project to have three separate capitals. To overcome the problem, he did what N.T. Ramarao first did in 1985.
I hereby dissolve the legislative council.
Like the center has Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, in the same way all states also have two houses, Legislative Assembly and Legislative Council, in what is known as a bicameral parliamentary system. By voting to abolish the council, Jagan made it a unicameral one, a single house, something the constitution permits under Article 169. Rajasthan, Assam and Tamil Nadu have also done the same. Emboldened after quashing the council, Jagan soon became
Jagni Khan.
He began cancelling one project after another that had been awarded under the previous Naidu administration. Infrastructure project in Amravati for startups, shopping and convention center in Vishakhapatnam, and the Polavaram Hydel project. Physically had demolished the Prajavedika or People's Grievance Cell, where Naidu used to hear complaints from the public. So vindictive did he seem that he was called
Jagan Mohan Reddy has become Radula Reddy.
But it is possible Jagan believes that by cancelling these projects, he is taking revenge on former Naidu associates who may stand to lose by the annulment. Jagan now requires funds and approval from the Law Ministry to shift the High Court from Amravati to Kurnool. To that end, Jagan is ardently wooing Prime Minister Modi, who may seek a return of the favour during the next general election. There are already petitions being heard in the court to block Jagan's plans.
No government office should be shifted anywhere till the petitions are heard.
Many countries have shifted their capital. Brazil from Rio de Janeiro to Brasilia. Netherlands from Amsterdam to The Hague. Pakistan from Karachi to Islamabad. Myanmar from Rangoon to Naypyidaw. Indonesia from Jakarta to Borneo Island. Australia from Sydney to Canberra. But the only example that matches Jagan's experiment of a country with three capitals is South Africa, Pretoria, Cape Town and Bloemfontein. Call it a maverick decision or a visionary one. Only time will tell, but the concept of decentralization is the right growth path for India.
Bisbo's limerick.
Jagan Mohan wants to decentralize the state. Don't you think his idea is great? Benefits spread, more butter and bread. It may even help him win on re-election date.
Subscribe to Bisbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bisbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.